Please pause for a moment of silence. Please stand for the pledges. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now for the Texas Pledge. Honor the Texas flag. I pledge allegiance to thee, Texas, one state, under God, one and indivisible.
Good morning, Eagles. I'm Novalee Iglesias, and on today's show, we have information on flower sales and the SAT preparation course.
And my name is Dominic Wheeler, and today is Monday, February 10th. This and more up next on Eagle TV. Eaton's Floral Expression is holding their annual Valentine's Day flower sale Friday, February 14th, during all lunches. A single stem rose is $2 and three roses are sold for $5. Other items for sale include a three stem rosebud vase, a three stem tissue bouquet, a basic dozen rose arrangement, and a high end dozen rose arrangement. Flowers may be purchased with cash, check, or credit card. Pre-orders may be made by February 13th will be held for pickup on February 14th in the Floral Lab D115.
Eagles, be sure to get your permission slip and $5 turned into any AP office for the big event.
Eaton High School is offering an SAT preparation course leading up to the March testing date. The 5-week course begins today and runs through March 20th. Interested students should see Mr. Hunt in room C213 or Mrs. Leaf in room C223 for more information.
Eaton's Diversity Club stopped by the studio to talk to Gable about Black History Month.
Good morning, Eagles. I'm Gabriel Bass, and today I am here with
Grace Fernandez-Sigua,
Dominic Wheeler,
and I'm Vinny Chorizo.
And we're going to be talking about Black History Month. Yes. What is Black History Month?
Black History Month actually began as Negro History Week in 1926, and it was just a time to remember Black activists that came before us, just in any importance, just remembering what they've done, and as well as celebrating them for that. And then eventually it became recognized as a whole month now.
And what does Black History Month mean to you?
For me, Black History Month, essentially the education system has always taught us one part of Black history, or history in general. And I feel as though, as someone who wasn't born in the United States, it's really important that we educate people on what Black History Month is, because it's a time to celebrate, recognize, and give reverence to the people who essentially built this country.
For me, Black History Month is not as well represented as it should be. I, being a young Black male born in America, I don't get to see what my people did in our education system, like you said, because we are limited to slaves is Black history, which it is not. We built the White House. We built railroads. Gladys West invented the technology to use the GPS system. Like, we did so much, and we don't get to see that in school. We are just limited to this is what, not to offend, but this is what the white man did. The white man invented this, that, and the third. The white man colonized this, that, and the third. And it upsets me that I don't get to see what my people did, what our people did here in America and in where we originated in Africa, so that just upsets me.
Well, for me, like Dominic mentioned, Black history didn't begin with slavery, nor did it end with President Barack Obama. So it's always been a moment to learn. There's so many things that we've done that's not recognized. You know, we're more than just entertainment and sports, but there have been advancements in technology and science that have been created by Black inventors and Black scientists, but we don't really get to recognize and celebrate them for that. And so I think that's the time for everybody to kind of recognize a group of people that have put so much work into building this country and leaving an impact, and finally celebrating them for that effort.
That's all we have for you today, Eagles. Thank you for this interview.
Thank you for having us. Do you want to give something special to someone on Valentine's Day? Today is the last day DECA will be taking pre-orders for pickup on February 13th or 14th.
stop by the cafeteria, Eagle's Nest, room E107, A127, or from any marketing student. Strawberries will be available while supplies last on Thursday and Friday.
And that's all we have for you today, Eagles. I'm Novalee Iglesias.
And I'm Dominic Wheeler, and this has been Eagle TV. Let's make it a great day, Eagles.